What's up? Flutter Mentor here, and let's learn how to use gradient colors in Flutter. And let's just jump right into it. What we're going to do is take this container that takes up the whole space of the app, and we're going to give it a gradient color. Now, the first thing we're going to do is remove the color because we're going to access the decoration property. And once you do that, you can't really use the color property because the color property is just a shortcut to a box decoration that then uses this property right here. But we're not going to use it because we want gradients. Now I'm going to start with the widget that you're going to use the most. Honestly, I don't really use the other ones, especially sweep gradient. So let's focus mostly on the linear gradient. The only required parameter is the colors. So let's go for it right now. And what it takes is a list of colors, which is pretty logical because a gradient never has a single color. As always with a list in Dart, you use the square brackets. And now we're just going to pick the colors. Let's do colors.red. And then colors.yellow. And just like this, if you save it, it already works. And this is pretty much the classic gradient, which is why you're more likely to use the linear gradient widget the most. But I'm guessing you want to control the gradient a little bit more than just going left to right. You just have to select the property begin first. And what this takes is an alignment geometry, which pretty much means that you can just come here and say alignment dots, and then here you have pretty much every direction. For example, let's do red going from here to yellow over here. So the beginning would be bottom left, and then the end would be top right. And just like that, it works. It begins with the red here and it ends with the yellow here. And now let me just add a couple of more colors. And I'm going to show you the stops property. Now this property takes just a list of doubles and each double represents a color. So in this case, we have four colors. So we're going to use four doubles and the first double is for the red color and the last double is for the green color. Here we do, for example, 0.2 for red, 0.3 for orange, 0.2 for yellow and 0.5 for green. If I hit save, it doesn't look pretty, but I think you get the point. Green has the biggest value, so it takes up the most space. Then red and orange kind of mix, and the yellow just decided to be weird. Let's change it, for example, for a 4 and see how it changes there. Now it's mixing a little bit better. And honestly, these numbers can be confusing sometimes, but just play around with them until you get the result that you want. And by the way, the more colors you have, the harder it will be to implement exactly what you want. For example, I'm going to use the rainbow now, and I'm not going to use the stops because it just gets messy. And let me quickly add the rainbow. There it is. I'm gonna hit save and there it is, a beautiful rainbow. And real quick, let me just show you a transparency trick that you can do. Let's say instead of purple and red, they're both red. I'm gonna hit save. And obviously this isn't cool, but you can just use dot with opacity. The value is from 0 to 1 and you can define the opacity of the color. For example, let's do 60% of red and full red. If I save it, this is a very simple way to just make the color a little bit more interesting. Maybe 60 is too little. Let's do 80. Now you see that? It looks pretty cool. It's just like red, but not full red. And this works with anything. You can also do a color on your own like this. And let me just throw some random numbers to get a random color. There it is. And let me put it here. And it works the exact same way. And boom, a much more interesting random dark greenish color right there without even complicating anything. In fact, if we do end, or rather begin bottom left and then end dot top right, and we save this, that looks pretty cool and it was very simple to do. And it looks much better than a boring standard solid color background. And that pretty much covers the linear gradient. Let's go on to the radial gradient. And just by hitting this, you see that there's no beginning or end. And I'm gonna hit save just so you see what happens. The radial gradient, pretty much as the name says, is more focused on a radial style. And the way you control this, you also have the stops here, just like in linear gradient. What people usually focus on is the center, where it is located. In this case, you can do, for example, alignment dot top right, and then it goes on the top right, kind of like a rainbow sun. And then you also have the focal point. For example, I can change this to bottom center and see what happens when I do this. Goes crazy. Basically, you're just selecting the focal point at which it begins, and then it just focuses towards where you place the center of the radius. Might be a bit confusing, but just play around with it. And we also have the radius double. And just so you don't get confused, let me save this beforehand. There you go. And here, let's say if we use one, it grows bigger. If it's two, it grows even bigger. And yeah, you probably already know how this works. The bigger you do it, the bigger it gets. 0.5, so it gets smaller, etc. Now let's go over to the sweep gradient. there's no radius property. Let me comment this out and I'm going to save it. And this is what it looks like by default. Obviously, if these two colors blended better, it would work better as well. In fact, let me do something here just to show that. Just a regular purple. I'm going to hit it. And as you can see, now it's more blending. But you still have this rough edge. But still, it's a pretty neat effect. And if you do change the center, then this center right here goes wherever you want it to. Obviously, it doesn't look very good. Let's change it maybe to bottom center. Looks a bit better, but you don't really get to see all the colors. But let me just quickly show you. These are the two properties, start angle and end angle. And if you use control key right here, you will see that the default value for start angle is 0 and the default value for end angle is math.py times 2. If you use 6, it pretty much does the default. And then with the start angle instead of 0, this goes from 0 to 1 essentially. That's the goal. For example, 0.5, you'll change a little bit, and then 0.9. As you can see, basically the angle changes. And you can even do something crazy like this and just make it all purple. And for example, just 7 will make it disappear. Play around with it. Like, for example, now that looks pretty cool. And that's essentially it. I'm just going to leave it at this so I don't confuse you any further. I hope you did learn how to use gradient. I hope you understood that you should yourself play around with it and see its limits. My biggest advice is always come here, hit control space, and just try out all the properties and see what they do. Which is pretty much what I just very quickly showed you. But it's always best when you do it yourself. So without anything further to add, I'm just going to leave this at a rainbow. Thank you for watching. That's it for today. This is Flutter Mentor. And out.